The session is live from Amsterdam and will be presented from Farwa, and it's a paper entitled "A Payload Optimization Method for Federated Recommender Systems."
Thanks for the introduction. Hello, everyone. I'm Farwa, and I recently completed master's in data science from National University of Computer and Emerging Sciences, Pakistan. And my research is in collaboration with Helsinki Research Center, Huawei Technologies, Finland. So what is federated learning? Maybe most of you know how what is federated learning, but it is actually a new machine learning paradigm where the user's data never leaves the user devices. Instead, model training is carried out onto the user's devices. And owing to new privacy rules, it has introduced new ways to build recommender systems where there is no longer need to collect and store user's data onto the central server. So here in the figure, we have FL server and the FL users. And in each communication round, server sends the global model to each participating user. Users use this global model and their locally stored private data to update their local models, which is further used to generate recommendations and model updates. And then these model updates are sent back to the server to aggregate the updated results to be used in the next iteration. So in the context of federated recommender systems, we introduced a novel payload optimization method. So a prominent direction of research in this domain is based on federated collaborative filtering that actually extends the standard collaborative filtering to the federated mode, where users receives the item factors from the server, and the update of the user factors is independent of all other users. So every user update the user factors using an optimal solution from standard collaborative filtering, whereas update to the item factors is dependent on the user factors of all the users, so its update cannot be done locally. Instead, server updates the item factors following the stochastic gradient descent and the local model updates from the users. But there exists a key challenge of computational payload in FCF or other similar recommender systems. Because to achieve convergence, it requires several communication rounds between the server and the users. And the computational payload in each round depends on the size of the global model. And in our case, the size of the global model is number of items into the number of factors. So the model payload depends directly on the number of items, and it increases linearly with the increase in the number of items. And here in the table, we have shown that recommender system items ranging from 3,000 to 10 million can have a payload exceeding 1 GB, which is quite huge. So the requirement to transmit a huge payload over several communication rounds becomes challenging for recommender systems running in production mode. To tackle this payload optimization challenge, we formulated a solution that is based on multi-armed bandit, a classical approach to reinforcement learning, where the key idea is that in each round, instead of transmitting the full payload, our method intelligently selects a part of the global model to be transmitted to all users. And this bandit model works at the server side, where at first it samples a set of items from probability distribution, and then it performs a certain action by selecting a particular set of items. And then based on these items, FL server subset the global model. And then following the FCF, users update and send the local model updates as part of FCF. And then these feedbacks or the local model updates are considered as the observations. And then based on these observations, we estimate our reward. And then this estimated reward is used to update the parameters of the probability distribution. And this process continues until the number of maximum iterations reached. So our proposed solution composed of two main ingredients. Number one, a sampling strategy for an optimal selection of items. And for this, we used well-known Bayesian-Thompson sampling. And the details about Bayesian-Thompson sampling can be found in our paper. And secondly, a novel reward function based on feedbacks gathered from FL users. So basically, this reward is actually changes in the gradients regularized by number of FL iterations, where gamma represents the regularization term and T represents the iteration. And the quantities QT minus 1 and QT are the gradients from the previous and the current iteration, where V records an exponential decay of the past squared gradients. So what this reward actually do, during the initial FL iterations, only those items are selected whose gradient changes are large. Whereas in the later phase, or with the increase in the number of FL iterations, the items are selected based on the overall similarity of the gradients to enable the favor convergence. So now we are moving towards the evaluation criteria in the experimental section. For the datasets, we used MovieLens, LastFM, and Mine, where the number of interactions represents the number of observed user item interactions, and sparsity refers to the percentage of unobserved user item interactions in the training dataset. For the comparison, we used FCF original, which actually uses full global model, and then we introduced FCF random and top list. So FCF random selects part of the global model based on items that are selected at random, whereas the performance of the top list is estimated using 100 most popular items ranked by their interaction frequencies. For train test, we use 80-20 ratio. And we analyze the performance at different percentage of payload reduction. And for the evaluation, we used well-known evaluation measures. So here is the recommendation performance. For the simplicity, here I have shown precision, but similar pattern of results found for other measures. So x-axis is representing the different percentage of payload reduction, where y-axis left side is showing the precision and right side is showing the performance degradation. And overall results suggest that our proposed method or solution outperformed FCF random and top list in all three datasets, whereas its performance closely matches the upper bound in case of highly sparse datasets such as LastFM and Mine. And it yields substantial performance gains for top list using only 2% of the data for LastFM and 5% of the data for other two datasets. And here is the convergence analysis, where x-axis is showing the number of FL iterations ranging from 1 to 1,000. And we observed that FCF original reached the optimum between 200 to 250 iterations, whereas our proposed method reached the optimum and closely matches the performance of FCF original on highly sparse data sets between 400 to 450 iterations. Further details or analysis of on the results can be found in our paper. So in summary, we tackled the challenge of increasing payloads using multi-armed bandit with normal reward function, and our method achieved 90% reduction in payload with minimum loss of recommendation performance. So as a future work, it would be interesting to investigate whether similar results will be achieved in context of larger datasets or recent or using recent and advanced federated recommender systems. And the next step would be to study the theoretical properties reflecting upon convergence and the regret bounds for the normal reward function. So we would like to acknowledge all the enormous reviewers for their helpful comments, and I would like to thank RecSys for giving me a chance to come here and represent my work. So thanks for your attention. I would be happy to take any question. Thank you.
Okay. Hi, Farwa, thank you. There is one question which is the most popular question in this session, is if you're planning to make the source code available.
Okay, we didn't plan to make it available yet, but yeah, there is a possibility. There is a possibility that we could make it available in future.
Okay. Any question from the audience? Okay, while we see, while we wait for some more questions coming, I will ask one. I've noticed that different data sets lead to quite different precision values, and I've noticed that also the size of the data sets is quite different. Is there any connection between the two?
We actually tried to analyze our method on different types of data sets with different statistics. If you observe the data sets, one of the datasets has higher number of items and less number of users. One of the datasets has lower number of items and higher number of users. And one is like they are more or less same users and items. So we wanted to just analyze that how the difference in the amount of data can impact the performance.
Okay, thank you. There is another question coming from the online audience, which is there any reason that your method does not reach optimal in MovieLens, since it is successful in the other two data sets?
Yeah, that's a good question. Actually, we are also analyzing this thing that why is it happening? It might be because of Movilens has lesser number of items, and it is not more sparse data sets. But if you observe the last film in the mine data set, it is quite sparse, which is usually a case in production system. When we look at the production, we usually came across the data sets that are highly sparse in nature. But yeah, for the movie lens, for the moment, I could say that it might be because of lesser sparsity or lesser number of items.
Okay, thank you. Any question coming from the audience here? Because we have sometimes formal questions. Okay, I don't see more questions coming online, but I invite you to go to the app because for sure there will be more coming. So let's thank our speaker again. Okay, so this concludes our session, and we have 30 minutes of coffee break, and then we're coming back for the last session of today. Thank you.
To the floor and me see your energy because me not play no hide and seek. What is the thing you ever make me feel weak, girl? Free! Cause anytime I whine and catch it, the selector pull it up and put it for repeat, girl. Up, up, me up, not up, touch up, a dollar in my pocket, cause nothing in this world.